Now, this, by the way, isn't just bad science. It's miserable theology, of course. It's a disservice to all people of faith to imply that it's better for our children to remain ignorant of the world than to risk the possibility that by knowing about it, you may lose your faith. This should be familiar to you. This is what people claim where they're fighting in the Taliban and Afghanistan. Right? That's a clear example in madrasas where children are taught nothing, or taught how not to think. And specifically because if they think, there's a fear that it might threaten their belief in Islam. But this is exactly the same notion here. There's nothing different about this approach. Keep children ignorant. Now, the marketing strategy has been very effective. It's the marketing strategy for intelligent design is based on some notions that really resonate with the American public. Open-mindedness. Listen, we should be open-minded about all of the issues, and we shouldn't be dogmatic about things like evolution. Honesty. Let's be honest about the fact that most people don't believe in evolution. And the one that really resonates, fairness. It's only fair if most Americans don't believe in this that we introduce in the schools the alternative. And that latter one particularly resonates with the public, but they all do. The problem is it's really garbage. All three of these are just invented. Because in fact, what the public really should see is that this is closed-minded, dishonest, and unfair. It's closed-minded for the reasons I've already shown you. The Discovery Institute now claims that they're a scientific organization whose sole purpose is to do good science, and evolution is not good science, and they like to explore the scientific alternatives. What you saw, of course, the statement at the beginning was that science, you know, it didn't say we're gonna do some experiments to see if evolution is wrong or science is wrong. It's, no, science without God is immoral. We've made that decision, and therefore evolution, which is science without God, must be wrong. That's what we call closed-mindedness. Open-mindedness is when you force your beliefs to conform with the evidence of reality rather than the other way around. Okay? So the whole purpose in that effort is closed-minded. But it's also dishonest. Let's talk about this famous controversy that they're talking about. Where's the controversy? Well, a few years ago I had a colleague of mine do a survey at over 10 million articles in 20 major science journals during a little over a decade, and look for keywords, evolution, okay? Hit that keyword evolution and got about 115,000 articles. Did do an exhaustive study, but most refer to biological evolution. Intelligent design, hit the keywords. Well, it appeared in 88 articles, but all but 11 of those were in engineering journals where they're supposed to be intelligent design. Of the remaining 11, 8 of the articles were in fact critical of intelligent design, and the remaining 3 were actually in conference proceedings. So in the scientific literature, there's nothing there. There's nothing. Now, the argument is made, especially when I talk to debate people in the Discovery Institute, that of course there's nothing in the scientific literature because scientists are censoring out this information. They have a prejudice, and they won't let articles on intelligent design get published. Now, I've had one of my responses, I've issued a challenge, which has yet to be met. I said to them, if any of you can prove that you've been rejected from scientific journals more frequently than I have, I will grant you this. Okay? No one's been able to prove that. Okay? But they also say, well, look, you know, we've given up, so we write books. Look, Darwin wrote a book, so we can write books. Well, Darwin wrote a book, he also submitted articles to the Royal Society, but okay. Said, okay, let's look at books. Forget the peer-reviewed literature. So I did the next thing. I went to Amazon.com, and I hit keyword evolution. I got that particular day, I got 21,822 books and articles appearing with the keyword evolution. And again, I didn't do an exhaustive study, but most of them referred to biological evolution as I scanned through it. I hit the keywords intelligent design, 635 hits. Now, about half of those were engineering, so get rid of half of them. And so only half of them were about ID in a scientific or religious sense. Half of the remaining ones were critical of ID, therefore about 150 books and articles that were promoting the notion of intelligent design. Okay. Just for fun, I hit the keywords alien abduction. Got 165 books. So you see, if there's a raging controversy that we should be teaching about in the schools, It's alien abduction. Much as intelligent as I, in any case. So there is no, it's just invented. There's no such thing, there's no controversy. There's a public controversy about an issue that doesn't exist. But the worst part is the fairness issue, because here's how science is done. Often. Not always, but often. The good thing is to start out with a novel claim. It's not required, but it helps. And then we do. Well, then you do research. What's research? You do the thing that Feynman said. You try and prove this idea right, and then you try and prove it wrong. Okay? And then, if you're convinced the idea has merit, then you submit it to a journal. What happens? It gets sent out for peer review. What's that? Well, that means it gets sent to idiots. And they come back and they explain to you, without having read the piece really, what they think is wrong and why they weren't referenced. And then you write back to them using small words. And then maybe, if you're lucky, the thing is published. But you know, lots of garbage gets published in every issue of physical journal, physical letters, or any major journal. There's lots of garbage. Doesn't matter, okay? Because what happens is, if it's really interesting, other scientists start to read about it and do research based on it, and then maybe eventually scientific consensus builds up. That may take decades. And only then does it make it into the high school textbooks. That's why high school physics texts are 20 years out of date, at least, usually. Because it takes a while. But what do the intelligent design advocates want to do? Well, they just want to get rid of all the intermediate steps, okay? Start with the idea and go directly to the high school textbooks. And that's just not fair. If you want to do science, or something you think is science, you should play on the same playing field. And you don't change science beginning in high school textbooks. That's not where science gets changed. It's changed in the laboratory